Hey everyone, and welcome to today's video. So one of the things that I'm not a massive fan of on the back of this car are the rear lights. So they are quality, so I've had a look over them. They work really well, so I'd fully recommend if people like this look to go for it. It's just for me, I'm not a massive fan of the Union Jack look on the back of the car. Now the one thing I do love, the fact is it's all pretty much red, so it's just a shame it has that Union Jack element to it, otherwise I would have kept it. So I think what I'll probably do is actually take a look at a facelift pair of lights and de-chroming those and putting them back onto the car. But for now, we're gonna get these removed. But the removal process is obviously exactly the same as the fitting process. So if you have the SMPS lights, which these are, or you just wanna switch to facelift lights, etc., as long as they're plug and play lights, this video will work for you. So what we need is just, from memory, is just a 10 mil socket. That's it. So we'll get the boot open and show you how to get these removed. Okay, so first of all, let's pop the boot lid. And you see, we've got this little plastic trim. Now, although mine is a GP and I've got no rear seats, you have this trim as well. So if you've got an R50 or an R53, you can do that. And all you do is pull down on the two little prongs at the top there, you can see, to pull that out the way. Then in here, there's a 10 mil nut. So you just need your ratchet, put it in and start undoing. What I'll do is I'll bring the camera around and show you the location of that. Okay, so if you can see in here, we've got this 10 mil just here. So I've already started to undo it with the socket. So I'll just get that out with my finger. You want to make sure the last bit you do with fingers so you don't drop that into the car. Now from memory, and we'll show you with the light off the car, there are two clips, metal clips that you depress. One, I think there's one at the bottom of the light. And I think that's it to get that out. So they're a little bit tight. So obviously with the older lights, they're quite soft. They might've been out a couple of times. This is a little bit more stiff, but I'll show you the backs of the lights when they're out, so you understand what I'm talking about with the clips. Okay, so as I was saying, you take that 10 mil off, you push on the clips on the back, and you can see it starts to, so I'm working on the clip on the top, and then I'll work on the clip on the bottom, and it should release from the car. And then there is a little connector that I'll show you on the back in a moment. Again, because these are new, everything's a little bit tight compared to old lights that have been in and out. There you go. So that's the back of the light. So you can see that's where the 10 mil bolt was. And these are the clips. They hook into the metal on the back there. So all you're doing is compressing those like that to release them and then doing the same. And then all I did was you've got this little plug here and you've got the little clip on the back that you just depress to pull it out of here. But you can see the quality of those lights are really nice. They've got a nice gasket on it. You can see running along there. So fit and finish on those, I'd say, is really impressive. So that is a thumbs up from SMPS. I'm just not a fan of the Union Jack, unfortunately. Okay, so the great thing about this GP that I bought is it came with all the OEM parts that had already been removed from the car. So the fact they'd fitted those aftermarket lights, they left the OEM ones in there. Now these are really clean and tidy, and you can see those aftermarket ones have the same clips, same bolt, same everything. So these are in really good condition, just peel off the plastic. So what I am gonna do is probably do a video later on the channel on how to remove the chrome from the inside of these. Now it's not for the faint-hearted, you do have to cut the lenses off, but I have a spare set coming that I'm gonna do it. So I'm not gonna do it to these original ones because these are in such good condition. But what we're gonna do is put these back in. Probably best to do the connector first. You just push that in, connect it in, and then all you do, just press the light in, making sure there's two little prongs just on this side of the light. It's making sure they don't catch your bodywork as the light goes in. You can come in from this side, make sure everything's lined up, and then give it a good push in. But again, make sure the two little prongs that stick out here, I'll actually show you on a spare light I've got, they can catch the bodywork if you're not careful. Okay, so if we come up close, see these, the two little prongs I was on about? So they, when I was putting the light in, could have caught that edge. You can see you've got it on this side as well. So you just make sure when you're pushing those in, those are away from the bodywork before you put them in. And again, all we do, we get our 10 mil, put it on the back. What you might want to do is just go and test your brake lights and your indicators. Just turn all your lights on just to make sure they work. But I'd already done that off screen, so I know these work anyway. But it's always a test when you're fitting new lights, just to make sure that they're working, because obviously it's dangerous if you're then on the road driving with no brake lights, indicators, etc. Now with the bolt on the back, they're actually loose on this car. You want to make sure they're done, not super tight, like you can snap the bolt off, but the nuts need to be done up tightly so that they're holding the light in place. Because obviously you saw on the back of that aftermarket light, we had like a rubber seal. You want that to have a good bit of compression on it so it stops water, because I know people have had water ingress into their boot, so where your battery box is on the R53. If you don't do these up tight enough, water can get in via this sort of big hole that you've obviously got behind the light. So it's just making sure that when you do it, you don't over tighten them, just get it enough where it pinches. So there's a little washer on the back of the bolt. What I make sure is that little washer isn't loose, because it was flapping about when I went to take these lights off from the previous owner. Okay. And that's that light fitted. Okay, so we're gonna do the exact same on this side. So just get our 10 mil socket on the back and just get that light out. This is the side that was actually loose. Now there is a bit of water in the battery tray on this car, so I'm 99% sure it's probably coming from this rear light being loose. So again, just push those clips on the back, start on the top, I tend to find easiest, but not always. It is tricky, especially if it's the first time you've done it. Sometimes they can get a bit stuck behind, so just wiggle it out. Undo the clip and make sure you don't catch the back of your car while you're doing that, because obviously this can be quite sharp and dig into your paint. And that's that off. And again, back in with the OEM one, do that clip up. Remember what I was saying about these tabs, just make sure you don't catch your paintwork. Obviously line up the threaded section. It's just making sure, it tends to be closer on this side than that side, but I know on my previous R53, it really annoyed me. I had it resprayed in Porsche RS Green and I actually caught the bodywork fresh from the paint shop fitting the lights. It really annoyed me for years. So just make sure you don't do that. This one got a couple of little marks on it, but again, they're superficial. They'll polish out with a bit of polish, so not too worried. But for me, it's just that Union, if it wasn't for the Union Jack, I like the solid red color in those rear lights, but the Union Jack just wasn't for me. And I know not everyone likes the chrome in these, neither do I. So that's one thing I'm definitely going to be sorting with a spare pair of lights. So look out for that video later on the channel. We'll probably speed this clip up a bit because it takes a while, because there's not a lot of movement in the ratchet spanner to get these in. But you can see, nice and solid. And you'll feel the resistance when you know it's ready to stop doing up. Again, like I said, you don't need them sort of as if you feel like you're about to snap the bolt off the back, but nice and solid and in. Okay, and then once you're done, don't forget to slot these back in. And they should have the little lip on the bottom. Make sure that's hooked over. They should just slot in place. There you go. And we'll do the same on the other side. There you go, and they're in. Okay, so hopefully you found today's video useful. So obviously we've got the removal and fitting of new rear lights or tail lights in America. It doesn't have to be GP, that's the exact same process again for the R50, R53, R52, and the GP, etc. So it's super easy, 110 mil, and you're off in two clips. That's it. So if you found today's video useful, please hit that like button, subscribe and hit the notification bell so you get alerts every time we upload new content. So hopefully you've found in the last couple of videos, so this and the GTT brace video, that the audio is a lot better. So I've been out and purchased these Lark M2 microphones. I want to try and improve the quality of the videos. So currently, again, filming on an iPhone. I want to try and get the new, the latest iPhone when that comes out later in the year as well, so we can upgrade again in terms of the video quality. But hopefully, for the next 6 months or so, you'll notice an improvement in the audio and hopefully the visuals, as I want to try and just make sure everything's framed a bit better and the quality of the videos are up there. So thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.